Hello students, we already discussed few topics of wave optics: Huygens principle, reflection and refraction on the basis of wave theory we discussed. Next topic is interference of light and Young's experiment. So what is meant by interference? Interference means when two or more waves superimpose in a medium, the energy of the wave is redistributed. The phenomena of redistribution of light energy due to the superposition of light waves from two coherent sources known as interference of light. A road where oil from vehicle has leaked out. These colored streaks are formed due to interference of light reflected from the oil film on water. Similarly, you have seen that soap bubbles appear colored in sunlight due to interference of light reflected from the soap bubble. Peacock and other birds show multicolors due to interference of light. So these all are already you have seen in our life. Now, what is the scientific concept of interference? That we have to go in detail. Anyway, interference shows the wave nature of light. Next is coherent and incoherent addition of waves. Before that, we will discuss about what is meant by superposition principle. Superposition principle means that when two or more waves advancing through a medium, at any point, the resultant displacement due to these two waves is the vector sum of the displacement due to the individual wave. See here, this wave is here, that is y1 is the displacement of this wave is showing, and a1 is its amplitude, and y2 is the displacement of the second wave. Then the resultant displacement, that is here the amplitude is a2 and here the amplitude is a1, then the resultant amplitude A is equal to A1 plus A2. Here, actually, why it is A1 plus A2? See, these two waves, amplitude is different, but here the phase is same. What is meant by phase? Phase means state of vibration. Here, see, both the waves reaches its maximum at the same time instant. That means their phase is same. This is showing that these two waves are in phase, but their amplitudes are different. Here, see, this wave is, see here it become maximum and here it become minimum. That means these two waves are out of phase. How much is out of phase? Because this full it is 360 degree. Then here to here it is 180 degree. That means these two waves are out of phase by 180 degree. So out of phase by 180 degree, because of that the resultant displacement is A2 minus A1. That means here the subtraction takes place because these two waves are out of phase. So what is meant by constructive superposition and destructive superposition? Here the resultant displacement added. So this is the example for constructive superposition. Here the displacement is subtracted. So this is the example for a destructive superposition. Now see here what is meant by superposition principle. According to superposition principle, the resultant displacement of a particle at any instant is the vector sum of the individual displacement caused to the particle by the two or more waves. Y is equal to y1 plus or minus y2. That depends upon they are in phase or out of phase. Now we will see the constructive superposition and destructive superposition in detail. When two waves of same wavelength superimpose on each other in phase, crest of one wave falls on the crest of other wave, or trough of one wave falls on the trough of other wave, then the superposition is constructive. That is, y is equal to y1 plus y2. Here say y1 and y2, and the resultant wave is showing by that are the red outline. So see here, the resultant displacement is more than the individual wave. Destructive superposition. What is destructive superposition? When two waves of same wavelength superimpose on each other out of phase, that time the crest of one wave falls on the trough of other wave and vice versa, then the superposition is destructive. In this case, the resultant displacement of the particle is given by y is equal to y1 minus y2. See this diagram, you can see that y1 and y2, here the red line shows the resultant displacement, that is less. Now, if both the waves are of the same amplitude, then in destructive superposition, the resultant displacement is zero. Next, we have to see what is meant by coherent and incoherent addition. What is the meaning of coherent sources and incoherent sources? See, here two vibrating needles are there. These two vibrating needles already put in water, and we have to start to move these two needles together at the same time. Then you can see that ripples will be formed like this. So you can consider that these two are so two sources, S1 and S2. This S1 source and S2 source, it is sending out the waves, and at any instant of time both the waves are in phase. So this is the case of coherent source. Suppose if you start to vibrate one of the needle little late, then the waves produced by these two needles are not in phase. So that is the example of incoherent sources. So here we are considering the coherent source of light and the incoherent source of light. See what is meant by coherent source of light. There already I have shown you what is meant by coherent source of light. Here two sources of light are said to be coherent if they emit waves of same frequency and are either in phase or have a constant phase difference. There you have seen that when we move both the needles together, that time what happened? The waves produced that are coherent waves. See here, this is the parent source, and here two sources are there, S1 and S2. We made two slits here. These two slits acts like a small source, that is actually a virtual source, and we are getting two individual source from a single source. Here these two sources are made from this single source. Because of that, these two sources are coherent. Two independent sources never be coherent. That we will see in the next topic. Next is incoherent sources of light. What is meant by incoherent source? The sources having different frequencies or sources having same frequency but no constant phase difference are known as incoherent source. Two independent sources can emit light of same frequency or wavelength, but their phase difference may not be stable and it may vary from 0 to 2 pi. Thus, two independent sources of light are not coherent sources of light. See, when we consider these two independent sources, it emits light, but their frequency may be same, but the wavelength is same, amplitude may be same, but the phase difference is different, because you know that here the light is produced by the filament. The filament, it is made up of a tungsten or any other metal. So how the heat, light energy is produced? Because of excitation. When the atom excite, that time what is the phase of this, all the atoms of the first lamp and the second lamp, they are of same phase, we cannot say that. That is why it is told two independent sources never be coherent. That is why in previous case we made two coherent sources from a single source.